Apple's Time Machine is a straightforward backup option for Macs you would be crazy not to use. It makes it easy to get back to individual files or completely restore your Mac when it's repaired or upgraded. But having to manually connect and eject a hard drive every time you're at your desk means that a backup probably isn't going to happen enough. That's where something like the UNAS 2 comes in. Ubiquiti's new UNAS 2 promises to be a powerful, easy to manage solution for backing up your home computers and sharing files without a cloud service. You don't even need to have any other Ubiquiti hardware on your network to get started with this NAS. And at $199 starting price, it's a lot cheaper than other alternatives I've talked about on this channel, like a Mac Mini home server. But the UNAS 2 is also an opinionated product with an interesting aspect missing. What's making me just focus on it as a Time Machine drive, you might ask? Well, there are other features of the UNAS 2 you might find helpful, and we'll get into them at the end of the video. Taking it out of the box, my first impression is that the UNAS 2 looks great. Ubiquiti sent me the white version, but it also comes in black. They also included 2 8-terabyte hard drives. Keep in mind, this video is not sponsored, although I did get this product for free. And you can get private label hard drives direct from Ubiquiti, but third-party hard drives like NAS-grade ones from Seagate, Western Digital, or other drive companies are totally fine too. Another thing you might notice right off the bat is the screen on the front. This is really useful, but a little bit different than screens in other Ubiquiti products, in that there's no touch screen here, it's just for display. There's also a USB-C expansion port. This could be nice to temporarily share a drive, but keep in mind that USB-C drives are not usually NAS-grade storage capable of handling all the reads and writes a network drive does. Now, speaking of the hard drives that go inside, installing the hard drives in the NAS was super easy. When I reviewed the first generation Ubiquiti UNAS Pro, I complained that the drive slots weren't technically toolless. The new UNAS 2 drive bays are. They just snap into place. The drives come out from the bottom and stand up vertically when the device is in use. This means if you have to change a drive, you'll need to shut the NAS down before doing so. But in a 2-bay network attached storage, that's understandable. On the bottom of the drive is another surprise. The only port is an Ethernet jack. This is compatible with speeds up to 2.5 gigabits per second and also powers the device with PoE++ power over Ethernet. Ubiquiti says on their website that a PoE adapter is included in the box. I did not receive one with my review unit. This isn't that unusual for early review units from companies to be missing small things and shouldn't be a problem for you, but I wanted to call it out anyways. For my initial setup, I have PoE++ in my Ubiquiti USW Pro Max switch, so that made the setup easy. But keep in mind that you don't need to have any kind of Ubiquiti hardware on your network, and in a minute, we'll test that configuration. Once you plug it in, you'll see instructions on the screen to download the Ubiquiti app. The app detects the NAS over Bluetooth and walks you through the adoption process, as Ubiquiti calls it, of adding this NAS to your UniFi account. Notice how this device installs UniFi OS and runs as a completely separate item to your other potential Ubiquiti products like a cloud gateway. Then you need to log into the NAS over your network to set up the storage pools over at unifi.ui.com. At first, it won't show much of anything over there as the NAS updates to the latest UniFi operating system. I was surprised that out of the box, it configured though a storage pool, by the way, basically just the place where you put a shared network drive or multiple drives. Well, it did all that with RAID 1. If you aren't as up on drive terms, what is RAID 1? Well, RAID stands for Redundant Array of Independent Disks. There are different standards for RAID, but the idea is that it's copying data so that if a specific drive fails, you haven't lost any data because copies of all the bits are spread across multiple redundant drives. What this means practically for being forced into a RAID 1 configuration is that if you add 2 8-terabyte drives like I did, you only get 8 terabytes of storage instead of 16. With a 2-bay NAS, I bet a lot of use cases is storing files of backup data that is also other places, like Time Machine backups. In this case, I'd prefer the increased speed and capacity of something like RAID 0 or maybe something like JBOD, if you know what that is. Once you have your storage pool, you can create and manage users as well. Each user gets a personal drive on the NAS. You can also create as many shared drives as you want. One detail Ubiquiti has improved here since the initial launch of the UNAS Pro is that you can back up Macs with Apple's Time Machine to shared drives, not just your personal drive. This is helpful if you, as the family tech support, might need to access a Time Machine backup for setting up a new machine in the future. You can also set a storage limit on shared drives, which could be helpful to contain a Time Machine backup or other file share. If, like me, you want to use this as a Time Machine destination for your Macs, you also want to ensure that storage box is checked and the user set a local password for Time Machine authentication. Theoretically, UniFi Identity, which we'll talk about in a minute, takes care of logging into the drives without this, but I find Time Machine works much better if the Mac has a password to connect on its own. This password is just for use on your local network and is there simply because network protocols like SMB don't have support for multi-factor authentication like maybe your Ubiquiti account does. I can't find anything about a limit of the number of users, but knowing Ubiquiti's main enterprise IT use case, I can't imagine you'll hit a limit here, particularly for home and small business use. As you create users, you can invite yourself and those other users to Ubiquiti UniFi Identity. This is a separate app that you download for your computer. And you might see all kinds of marketing around identity as an app for access in a workplace. And yes, there is that too, but not something you need to worry about here. Each user gets an email they need to click from their computer to open the UniFi Identity app and authenticate. Then on my Mac, I have another menu bar item that shows my UniFi Identity connection status. When I'm on a network with the drives available, UniFi Identity automatically mounts the shared network drives to my computer. This can be super helpful for getting quick access to files on the NAS when you're on the same network, but if you used another UNAS before, this is really nothing new. Since UNAS 2 doesn't require other hardware, like a Ubiquiti Cloud Gateway to function, what about taking this somewhere else? Well, I work most days out of a co-working space down in Geneva, Illinois, where I have a desk. This is a Cisco Meraki network and has zero UniFi hardware, but it's a place where my Macs connect, and having a Time Machine there would be a nice offsite backup from my home. Another similar scenario would be you as a UniFi home set up this UNAS 2 for family that lives in a different house to use as their Time Machine backup destination. You as the tech support can keep an eye on things remotely on the UniFi portal. Moving the NAS to the co-working space was super easy. I plugged it into the Ethernet port that I get with my dedicated desk, and then used a PoE adapter for power, and it just works with my laptop on Wi-Fi. I can also use the UniFi portal from my house to check in on my UNAS 2 in the co-working space. Now, I know what you're thinking. What about backing up drives between the locations? Due to the limitations of the network in my space, I haven't been able to get a bridge between the two NAS drives working. This is a great feature that UNAS drives have though, where you can remotely back up Ubiquiti NAS drives to another Ubiquiti NAS drive in a different location. But keep in mind, for a family use case though, that family might also have a data cap on their internet connection. So if you're remotely backing up big files or computer backups or lots of videos, that's gonna chew through any data cap pretty quickly. And that's why I think this use case of putting this as a Time Machine backup for Macs over on that network makes more sense. All right, so I'm here in UniFi Site Manager on my Mac, and I can go ahead and click on my mini NAS, as I called it. And you'll see here that I have one storage pool of Time Machine, and I can also get a sense I have not been there today, so there hasn't been really any data transferred recently to the device. But this could be nice if it's remote at a family's house and you didn't see data being transferred to the device when you'd expect. That means maybe the backups are broken and you need to look into that. I can check in on the storage pool, see that the drives are fully operational. And then if I go over here to remote backups, and I try and select a destination, It's going to try and connect and eventually fail. But I'm not blaming Ubiquiti for that. That's just my setup. And if I go over to services, you'll see that I have Time Machine checked for this, and it could link me to a guide of how to use Time Machine backups with this NAS. And I can even go in here remotely and create new shared drives. And I can also go ahead and add and remove users from this as well. So I could create a new user and then go ahead and invite them and then get the email. And I don't even have to be on site with this NAS for that to happen, which is pretty great. And that could be nice for the family use case, either if it's at another family member's house or just in your own and you're away from home. Once the drive is running, the display we talked about earlier shows the available storage space and transfer rates of the drive. I love that UniFi has this, and it makes it easy for anyone to check on the amount of free storage space. One other huge benefit of the UNAS 2 compared to other NAS devices I've tried, like Synology, is how quiet this is. Now, this depends in part on the hard drives you choose, but I hear very little noise from the drive, even when it's actually reading and writing. But Synology and other NAS companies have been in the NAS business for way longer and have a lot more software features built out. Like other UNAS products, Ubiquiti's UNAS 2 can back up not just to other UNAS devices, but also a cloud service like Google Drive or Dropbox. This is nice, but there's a critical, challenging feature that is missing to make it useful for me, and that's what I would call bi-directional sync. Whether talking to another UNAS or a cloud service, all the current features are about backing up data from the UNAS. What other NAS drives provide is syncing, where changes from either end are mirrored on the other location. This means that if someone adds something to a Dropbox folder, it would automatically show up in the related folder for me on my UNAS. Still, whether it's the UNAS Pro I use here at home or the UNAS 2 I now have at the co-working space, Ubiquiti's UNAS line has lots of features for a competitive price. The fact that you can buy this UNAS 2 for $200 without disks, combined with UniFi Identity for auto mounting on the Mac, makes this an ideal choice for backing up Macs with Time Machine, even if you don't have any other Ubiquiti hardware in your place. I'll leave an affiliate link to this NAS at the top of the description. If you found this video helpful, using that link helps support the channel at no additional cost to you. And if you're thinking you want to go all in with Ubiquiti, then check out my video I did earlier this year redoing my home rack setup. Thanks again so much for watching, and I hope to see you in the next video.